Vaccination makes some people uneasy, and it's not just the needle. The alarming claims we've all heard about the dangers of vaccines can make vaccination seem like a big risk to take. But humans' perception of what's risky is notoriously unreliable. We tend to underestimate the risks of everyday hazards and worry too much about suffering some highly unlikely misfortune. In fact, 9% of Americans fear zombies, which don't even exist. So it's not hard to see how lots of scary talk around vaccines can be paralyzing. In reality, the risks posed by vaccines are really small. In fact, because vaccines are preventative measures given to healthy people, they're designed to be safer and have fewer side effects than interventions like medication or surgery, which doctors only resort to if someone is already suffering from a medical condition. After chemotherapy, for example, nasty reactions are almost universal, and one of every two men who use Viagra experience at least one side effect. Yet the most common side effect of the measles, mumps, and rubella vaccine, a harmless low-grade fever, occurs in just one out of every six recipients. Less than 1 in 20 get a minor rash, and super serious reactions are super rare. Less than 1 out of every million recipients suffers a major allergic reaction. In fact, during your lifetime, you're about 3 times more likely to be killed by an errant firework, and 80 times more likely to be struck by lightning, than to have a severe reaction to the MMR vaccine. So, when the Center for Disease Control, World Health Organization, or your doctor calls a vaccine safe, they aren't saying it'll never trigger any bad reactions, they simply mean that its risks are overwhelmingly outweighed by its benefits. Shots for MMR, meningitis, and chickenpox reduce the risk of getting sick by at least 85%. Plus, vaccinating healthy people prevents nasty germs from spreading to those that are too young or weak to get vaccinated themselves. Overall, vaccines have reduced the number of whooping cough cases in the US by 97.5%, slashed the worldwide incidence of polio by more than 99%, and eradicated smallpox. But this success comes with its own side effects. As fewer and fewer people witness or experience the effects of these nasty diseases, it becomes easier to fixate on the risks of vaccines than to recognize their benefits. However, an encounter with illness can help put things into perspective. After a rash of measles spread through 27 US states in 2014 and early 2015, attitudes shifted nationwide. Over a third of Americans polled said they now viewed vaccines more favorably. And where outbreaks were particularly bad, behavior changed too. In hard-hit Clallam County, Washington, vaccination rates quadrupled. Any increase in vaccination rates is great for those that become protected, either directly or through herd immunity, but it doesn't help people who are already sick. It's better to learn before you get sick about how small the risks of vaccinations are compared to the risks of disease, because these guys are what you should really be worried about. Hey, Henry here. I'd like to thank Lynda.com for supporting this video. Lynda.com, as you may have heard, is an online learning website with over 3,000 video courses where you can learn and improve your business, technology, and creative skills. Actually, it's not just a website. They have mobile apps so you can learn on the go, too. If you'd like to try out Lynda.com yourself, head to lynda.com/earth for a free 10-day trial with access to all of Lynda.com's courses, like their videos about using Wacom tablets with Adobe Photoshop, which is how we illustrate our videos here at Minute Earth. Again, that's lynda.com/earth for a free trial and to let them know you came from our show.